Hi friends, this is Leela. Welcome to my channel. In the previous video, we have seen how we can modify the request object, that is whether headers or params or URL, anything through the intercept, how we can modify the data request of the HTTP we have seen, right? Not only the request, we can also through the intercepts, we can also get the response also. Okay, you need to remember that we can also get the response from the interceptors. And if you want to do anything with the response, you can also do the concept. So now what we can do, how we can take the response is, let's we'll see in this video. So before continuing to this video, if you are coming first time to my channel, please do support me by subscribing to my channel so that I will be posting more and more front-end development courses. Okay, coming to this video, now we have seen how we can modify the request. Now after request, the response, we will be getting the response, right? We can also modify the response through the interceptors. Okay, we can also get the response through the interceptors. Why? How? Because this next dot handle, if you see this next dot handle, it will go to the HTTP. So that means HTTP dot get, HTTP dot post, and all those things it will go, right? So that one will return a observable, if you understand. So there it will be returning an observable. So that observable means nothing but this next dot handle is nothing but an observable. Actually, this is nothing but an observable. Now this if it is an observable, means you can write your RxJS operators or subscribe. You can use dot subscribe here. Okay, so dot subscribe thing we'll be using outside the somewhere. So in this interceptor also you can use that subscribe. So now in this interceptor we can use the pipe also. Okay, you can use the pipe RxJS operators. Now how we can write, we can use the tap operator. We already know that it will not do anything. So if you want to do anything operators in between the HTTP after getting the response, if you want to do anything, so you can use interceptors like this. And here you will be getting event. You need to remember that we will be not getting the response, you will be getting the event. Event thing I already told you in my previous video. Observe, if you use the observe events, you will be getting the event. Event means if it is a type is 0, if it is a type is 4, for every event you will be this tap event will be fired. So whatever the things, if you keep the observe as a response or observe as a body or observe as an event or whatever the thing you keep and regarding it will not consider that observe option in the HTTP request. Okay, so now you will be getting an event. So if you try to print this event, console.log event dot, okay, event dot, so you can print whatever the thing, so you can print event. Now if I try to check the output here, so let it refresh. Okay, so if you try to check here, you are getting a type C. It is coming from the auth interceptor service. Okay, so if you click on here, you'll be able to see that you are getting the event. And for everything, so for whatever thing, so if you post, if you try to add the post, you are getting an event, and then after you are getting the response from the auth. So this one is type is 4. So now what we can do is, for example, you can check here the concept also. So if event dot type is equal to HTTP event type dot response. Okay, HTTP event type dot response. If it is a response, then console.log event dot body. You can print event dot body. So here you can write if you want console.log response from interceptor. Okay, you can write like this also. So now you got the response and event type. If you got the response then you will be getting the body. So that is the reason I am printing the body. So now if I try to refresh this one, so now you can see that response from the interceptor, type is equal 0. So that means request has been sent but we didn't get the response, so that's why body will not be there. Now when we got the type is equal 4 means then we will be getting the body. Now we are printing the body here. If you observe, we are printing the body. The same scenario, if you try to clear the posts also, the same thing happens. So here interceptor, we got request has been sent, and here you are sending the response from the interceptor, you are seeing. Okay, null, you are getting the null. So in this way we can get the response and we can modify that response also. If you want to modify the body response, you can use the map operator, you can change the data also, response also. So this is where we can access both the request and also the response through the interceptors. So this is all about the interceptors. concept, and we also have another interceptor, multiple, how to access a multiple interceptor. We'll check in the next video. So these are all the code. I will be posting it in the GitHub account. So below the description link, I will be posting that GitHub URL. So if you have any doubts or anything, so you can go, we can go to the GitHub repository and you can check the code. So this is all about the response interceptors. If you have any doubts or any suggestions, please post the comments below to this video. And if you like this video, do support me by subscribing to my channel. Thank you.